Bring Indian people, they're not Muslims, they run out this Hispanic.
Right.
They're all spirit souls, right? We don't care whether, you know, whether they're considered better or high class or whatever. In fact, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's room is especially that for those who are considered the most. Of course, in America they don't say it openly, but it's the WASPs consider Hispanics to be a lower race, and African Americans to be just above human.
Yeah.
But Chaitanya Mahaprabhu considers whoever chants Hare Krishna to be the best.
Look at the monkeys. They help Ram. And they're supposed to.
No, but it's a misconception anyway. That it's just that.
Yeah.
I mean, I don't want to get too much into politics, but South America could be well developed also if it wasn't for the politics of North America.
Definitely.
It's not that Latino people are less intelligent or less. I mean, there's so many great personalities in the material sense came out of the Latin country. Anyway, you can distribute books. You can go around here and distribute. You can do more books among the Latino
people.
Yeah, Srila
Prabhupada mentioned the same thing you do, so that these people, these Mexican people, they, even though they may not understand exactly what I'm saying, but they're drawn to whatever we're chanting and we're speaking. They're drawn like bees to honey, you know?
Yeah, they have a natural attraction for kirtan and they respect saintly people.
Yeah, that's true. I grew up in a Latin family in New York.
Which family?
A Latin family.
Latin.
My mother's from Cuba. My father's from Puerto Rico. So from the very beginning of my birth to this, I'm thinking of like natural respect for God, for anything spiritual. Thomas A. Becket had a profound experience for me in my life.
Really?
Yeah.
That book is.
No, actually, I saw that. I was sitting in the movie house and watching Richard Burton, Peter O'Toole.
Uh huh.
And the movie is Becket.
I'm getting mixed up. He was the one who was killed by the
king's
man. King Henry or something.
King Henry the Second.
Yeah.
Right.
I was getting mixed up with the one who wrote the there's that mystical book. Which one? Another one. Anyway.
I remember. Yeah.
You read it?
Saint Augustine as well.
Okay. Please.
Anyway, when I saw this movie, it really had a profound effect on my life, saying, you know, like, someday I have to surrender to God. And then a few years later, when I met the devotee, happy. That was, it's all working up to that. Because you know how
Krishna
is. In fact, I had an English, I lived in Montreal. I moved there because I was drafting the service in America. So this was 1969 and 68 actually, and Srila Prabhupada was there, but I didn't know. So, but anyway, one English friend of mine, she rented an apartment. Her name was Claire, and I went to see her as a good friend, casual friend, and I was lighting some incense in her bedroom while she was folding clothes and doing things, you know, and then I started to cry. Then later on, Bharadraj, he wanted to move from the Krishna house to the temple, so carrying his trunks and his luggage, and he pointed to that apartment. He said, you know, Srila Prabhupada was there in the summer. And I said, so, yeah, just the vibration that Prabhupada left there knocked me out, you know, crumbled me in me.
Well, I feel very honored to meet you.
Oh, no, likewise.
Because you did such a service. You actually opened up the preaching in a huge field. And then Spanish book translation, and it's just a huge service in the Sankirtan movement.
I hope I get blessed by Prabhupada before I leave the body. I can do something meaningful.
Well, you've already done so much. I mean, this.
Never rest, all right, you know, no matter what we do, we always feel incomplete because we feel that
Cuba's opening up, right?
Cuba's opening up. Yeah, yeah.
The devotees are going there.
Yeah. So, thank you for appreciating that. And likewise, look at this. It wasn't intentional. But, you know, it's somehow Celtic and England has a, I don't know, it's just, you know, how it rots your heart and your soul. You know, there's something that really draws you back there.
To England?
Yeah. Yes, very much.
It draws you back.
Yeah. It's something that going on there sometime before, I think. Maybe, you know, but you feel it because...
Well, it was a very mystical country until the Christians came and messed it all up.
Well, Thomas A. Becket is a good example.
Right, right. I mean, he there's so many people in that era were willing to die rather than give up their belief.
That's it. The king sends him out. I know you know the story, but the king sends him out to... you know, the Archbishop of Canterbury died, and so he thought, well, I'll bring my friend over there, and I can have the church, and stayed all.
Right.
But then when he gets there, he also feels the weight of serving God, and gave all away his gold and whatever he had from the king, and gave it to the poor, and finally he stood up for the rights of God and the church, and
over the
that
stone.
Cost him his life.
Yeah,
but he happily gave it because he's serving the real master.
They had such faith.
Yeah, willing to give everything. I'm very honored to meet you because I can see you're such a humble and sincere soul of Prabhupada.
Hare Krishna.
And this is Chaitanya Chandra Prabhu. And I, you know,
that one time there must have been two Chaitanya Chandras here.
There's
I met you with Bhakti Marg Swami. In Mayapur a few years ago, we crossed paths walking behind Mayapur, the little road back there.
Oh yeah, I was going to Rajpura, the Jagannath Mandir, by the back road. The back path, it's not really a road.
So Chaitanya Chandra for always helping and serving the devotees, and sacrificing his life. He was with Radha Damodar for many years.
Yeah,
and he's traveled all over the world also, doing preaching and giving his life and heart.
Hopefully someday.
Where did you go? China, I guess. You must have
I actually was in China, the Philippines. Stayed there for a year.
Fiji.
And then was here in the restaurant from the time it opened in '82 for 16 years, working in the restaurant and teaching for the people. And then got married and had some kids and changed things around a little bit. Recently we have these nice big parades that we enter into. We built a big parade float where we have a kirtan on top. And that's kind of been my service for the last few years now, is to travel around Texas. Just big parades and have some kirtan. And there's 200, 300, 400,000 people, many people.
Plus TV coverage.
Yeah, so it's newspaper. That's what we've been doing.
But we do like the little local thing. I still go to Mexico. I was just now for Prabhupada's 40th anniversary. We were the hosts there when he came. And, so I went back there recently. And but we try to do in Texas, at least some of us who are not living in the temple, but we try to get together and, you know, praise Prabhupada's glories and help other people on the outside, you know.
Huge field among
isn't it? Yeah.
And the Latinos itself is a huge field, right?
This could be. In San Antonio they have so many nice new devotees too.
Oh yeah,
Latino devotees, which is nice.
Where's that? Is that in,
south kind of
Texas.
Southern, well, southwest, south central, well, south central.
This is the border with Mexico. Here's Dallas, here's Houston, and over here is San Antonio. Just west of Houston. You know, more or less Austin.
So there's a nice Brahmachari devotee disciple of Bhakti Chirtamaraj there, Advaitacharya Das. He has a nice little preaching center there in San Antonio. He's done a lot of preaching and traveling. He did the big tour this year, the Warped Tour, where they have a lot of bands. And they're the ones that set the tent up, and they had like a little impromptu Bhakti program type crash course of Krishna consciousness
right on the spot,
right there inside the concert ground, you know. So that was really nice. They got like thousands of men.
1970s catching and shaving on the spot.
So you're mostly staying in
I've been based in India, actually.
Most of India, yeah. So
I wanted to thank you also for that beautiful book about Bhakti Siddhanta. That was really a grand book.
Did you see that?
Yeah, Maharaj Guru Prasad was near me about 5 minutes when he ever comes. He gave me a set of them, and I'm going to get down to reading them.
It's a big job to read.
Everyone loved it, enjoyed it. Somebody was telling me about the book, and it was very nice to hear. But please accept our humble obeisance.
Jai. Hare Krishna. I'm very happy to meet you. Unexpected. Hare Krishna. Is there any advice for these devotees?
Serve Maharaj. Sincerely engage in Prabhupada. So give him all your heart, and service, and attention. Do the best you can, right? And I know you're doing that already. I can see it in your faces. That's why you please Prabhupada.
Good evening.
Good evening. Remind me of giving, hugging Guru Prasad Maharaj is more bone than fat. Anyway, stay healthy and happy, and as you always are.
Okay. It's a good blessing. Yeah. Only possible in Krishna consciousness.
Yes, it's the only way.
Hare Krishna. Jai Chaitanya Chandra. Chaitanya Chandra Kuru Ke Anuragam.
We're delighted also to have met you. Consider a great blessing.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Jai Prabhupada.
Jai Srila Prabhupada.
Okay, let's go.